We will perform an experiment to see the characteristics of a semiconductor device that is known as a diode. So over here in this experimental setup, this is the experimental setup board. You can see all the devices are integrated on this board. Let's talk about the parts one by one. Over here you can see this black knob, which is known as the output control. This is giving you a DC supply. You can see the range is given from 0 to 1 volts. We will use this left hand side device, that is the range, for the forward characteristics. You can see there is a currenting resistance, and then we have got this black one is the PN junction. Apart from this, we have got a voltmeter and an ammeter. You can see over here, this voltmeter has got a dual range, that is 1 volt and 100 volt. When you place it at 1 volt, you will take the readings on the lower side. When you change it to the 100 volts for the reverse bias, you will see the readings on the upper side. Similarly, for the ammeter, there are two ranges, that is 1 milliampere and the 50 milliamperes. For this, you will take the upper and lower readings respectively. Now let's do the setup for the forward bias. This is how we will make the connections for the forward bias. From the supply, the positive terminal, it goes to the P side of the diode. You can see over here. Then we will connect the voltmeter in parallel to the diode. So you can see that the black wire and the red wire. We have connected the diode and the voltmeter in parallel. Next, from here, we will connect an ammeter in series. The negative side goes to the ammeter, and from here it comes back to the power supply. Hence our circuit is complete. Now let's switch it on and see how is the IV characteristics. Right now the readings are at 0 and 0. Slowly vary your input voltage. As you can see, now it is 1 volt, but the current is still 0. Now it is 0.2. Even at 0.5 volts, current is still 0. Now at 0.6, you can see there is a slight variation. You will take 4 or 5 readings for the 0 current. Now from here you will see from near 0.7, the current starts to rise rapidly, but the voltage is not varying much. So this is known as the knee voltage. Now look at the voltmeter. It is fairly stable and the value of current is varying. This is how you will see the forward characteristics of a PN junction. We will take 10 sets of readings and then we will plot a graph. Now let us plot the graph for the forward bias. So we are plotting a IV graph, that is the current on the y-axis. We are plotting a graph for the forward bias of the PN junction. So we are taking the voltage on the x-axis and current on the y-axis. The current is taken in milliamperes. As we have seen in the experiment, the initial set of the readings till 0.6, it comes out to be 0. So you will have 2-3 points over here. At 0.7, the current starts varying. So this would be the graph for the forward characteristics. And here you can see that it's nearly at point we have got the knee voltage.